place, and we're trying to say it's carbon dioxide. No, it's not, it's coffee. We can't judge the weather for tomorrow. So how are we going to predict it in 50 years' time? Now, I'm being a little bit, you know, silly, in one respect. If it is happening, we should be really cautious and all this sort of stuff. But it is such a complex thing. The newspapers love selling stories. The forecast for today, scattered arrows. So where are we? So the debate rages. Global warming and carbon dioxide, there seems to be a link. But if I take a hot bottle of Coke and I open the lid up, guess what happens? Everywhere. Why? Carbon dioxide doesn't like being dissolved in water when it's warm. So does global warming cause more carbon dioxide to be present in the atmosphere? And there's a lot of work that says as the temperature goes up, carbon dioxide goes up. But as the temperature drops, shortly afterwards, carbon dioxide starts to drop down because it's been dissolved in the water. The warmer it is, the more carbon dioxide comes out of the water. Or is it carbon dioxide levels result in global warming? In which case, we should stop driving cars now, and instead of flying back to Melbourne, I better walk. It's a long way. Is the level of radiation from the sun more important? Which is it? One thing we haven't even started to cover is that carbon dioxide goes into the sea. And this is the thing that happens to it, how it forms calcium carbonate and all this other stuff, and it goes on and on. So you've got the sea taking up carbon dioxide. You've got plants taking up carbon dioxide. We've got us pumping it out at a record level that we've never known before. We've got things happening along the way. What's the answer? I don't know. If you take all the carbon dioxide that we're producing, all of it, 70 million tonnes of CO2 per day, that's 25,000 million tonnes per year. If you dissolve that in seawater, there's a lot of seawater, it comes out to about 0.0002%. increase in carbon dioxide in the sea. That ain't much. So can the sea take up more? Dunno. They find that as carbon dioxide goes up, certain fish die, other things happen, the carbon dioxide goes bananas, etc., etc. Very complex what happens in the sea. Is that important? I don't know. And neither does anybody else. So what's the answer? I don't know. It's a bit of a headache. So when you go into it, the more you go into it, the more you realise that it's not just one thing. It's a difficult, incredibly complex, the sun's getting warmer, and we've got cars pulling out carbon dioxide, and we've got the sea taking it up, but it takes it up only to a certain amount. The good thing is someone does know the answer, and Pastor Vic mentioned it before. Through our wonderful world, we know we're making a mess of things. We've got pollution, global warming, population explosion. The plasticizer that's used in plastic pipes is a sex hormone, female sex hormone. And as you drink water in plastic pipes, after a while you start to get troubles of not being a bloke anymore. And it's been happening a lot. You can see it in fish. The sperm count of males has been dropping progressively in Europe for the past 30 years. And you can plot it exactly that as the plastic pipes increase, the sperm count drops down. We've got enormous problems that are happening. We don't have global warming, population explosion. We've got food being produced at an increasing rate, but the trouble is the wastage is going up, so we've got less food. God set up this earth and it ran beautifully for millions of years, and then we came along. God understands the complexities of the system. He's the only one who can. Where were you when I laid the foundations of the earth? Tell me if you understand it all. No, we don't. God knows. So what God also says, he's the only one who has the full answer to the big picture. He has an answer for your personal life. You can have a satisfying and provable experience direct from God. He will send the comforter. We know that he has the final control. So what does the Bible say about global warming? Not a lot. It just says, there's two warnings. It says, for then shall be great tribulation such as was not since the beginning of the world. To this time, no, nor ever shall be. And except those days should be shortened, there should no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days should be shortened. What does that mean? Not totally sure. Second warning, whereby the world that then was being overflowed with water perished, but the heavens and the earth, which are now, by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. They say, we're going to get flooded. No, we're not. The Bible says we're not. It just says, there's going to be some nasty times coming up. What we don't know is how to solve this world. Haven't got a clue. What God says is, save the saver, which is yourself. How do you get right with God? Do you sit down and mutter something on the ground? What do? The Bible's got a specific answer. The answer is, then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you, and to your children, and to all that are far off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. Save yourselves from this untoward generation. We don't know how to save the world. Science doesn't know how to save the world. We're pumping out chemicals so fast, we don't know what's good, what's not good. We don't know the combinations. It's only a short while ago we said asbestos was totally safe. Now, it's a terrible thing. Mercury. It was advised to take mercuric salts to make you feel better, only up to 1940. Now, if you take mercury, your hair falls out. Oh. We make mess of things because we don't understand the complexities of this body or of the universe. God says, well, you can't do anything about that. What you can do is save yourself. Get yourself right with God. Receive the Holy Ghost. Know for a certainty that he's alive. Then everything sorts itself out. And that's it. I'll hand back to Pastor Peter.